Live from Farmington High School, it's Tiger News.
Good morning, Farmington. Welcome to Tiger News. I'm Gunner.
And I'm Trinity. I can't believe we're almost done with the trimester already.
I know, I have a lot of catching up to do.
An update on the damage that came from Hurricane Matthew. In total, there was about $10 billion in damage. More than 1 million structures were destroyed and many were forced out of work. Insurance companies say that they will cover $4 to $6 billion of the damage done. Over 500 people died in Haiti and 34 people died in the United States. Hurricane Matthew cost over 5,000 jobs and is now the 22nd worst storm since World War II.
Drake has just canceled the remainder of his Summer 16 tour. The rapper had 3 remaining concert dates but has postponed them indefinitely due to an ankle injury. Drake suffered a severe ankle injury during the tour, which he did his best to power through, a spokesperson said for the rapper. By doing this, he made his injury worse. Drake had previously postponed 3 of his concerts due to the injury, which include Toronto, Philadelphia, and Newark. The latest cancellations affect 2 concerts in Brooklyn as well as another date in Newark.
Man, that kind of stinks for him.
I know, it sucks if you bought tickets already.
Yeah. This week, Noah Liebers got a chance to catch up with sophomore football player and Tiger News director Ethan Halverson.
My name is Noah Liebers, and this week I got to catch up with sophomore football player Ethan Halverson. I first asked him about when he started playing football.
I started playing football in first grade, and the reason I started playing would be it looked fun, and I wanted to be part of a team.
Ethan's teammates say he's a hard worker, and he's often in the weight room training to get better. Football is all about making big plays and big hits. I asked Ethan what his favorite part about playing football is.
My favorite part of playing football would be the fact of being on a team and being part of those big plays and being able to help the team win.
Ethan says football is all about playing on a team, so I decided to sit down with a couple of teammates to ask how they think he's been playing this year and how much he's improved.
I think Ethan's done really good this year. He's contributed to the team a lot. He's a great listener and he works really hard.
I think he's improved a lot this year, especially in the summer. He was out there on the field getting his reps, and I always see him in the weight room working hard.
Most student athletes know it's tough getting work done on time, so I asked Ethan how he manages to do it.
We have lots of practices after school, but just staying up late, finishing all your homework, getting good grades and all that.
Coaching is a very important job, so I asked Mr. Malin about how he thinks Ethan has done this year.
Well, I think he's improved a lot. He's been playing really well. He's done everything we've expected. He played summer football for us. I don't think he's missed a practice that I can remember. And so his greatest improvement is how much he understands the game. He's been playing free safety for us. And he understands when we're running a certain type of defense, exactly how to play that defense as a free safety. So that's important for a player, that he can understand that.
Reporting for Tiger News, I'm Noah Liebers.
And now we're going to stay tuned for sports coming up right after this.
Percy, read this.
All right. Oh my gosh. Really? Oh my. Jesus, you have to publish this.
Where? I don't know where to publish it.
Submit your short stories, poems, and artwork and more to the new lit journal called The Tiger. Submit it to tdoyle@isd192.org.
All right, sports teams seem to have done pretty well this past week. Kaylin's going to update us on that.
The Farmington girls tennis team played subscriptions in Rochester last night. Double teams, Alinka Regulus, Michaela Bauer, and Kirsten Hall, Jamie Ellis, played well, but each lost in the first round. Coach Jack Alwell stated that Farmington single players were each seeded in the 16-player draw. Ryan Jara, number 6, and Brooke Apuku, number 1. Both played well and held their seeds. Ryan won her first round match 6-1, 6-3, before losing a close one to the number 3 seed, 3-6, 6-7. Brooke won her first match 6-1, 6-1, and put into high gear in her semifinal winning, 6-0, 6-0, to advance to the section final tour on Tuesday. Good luck, girls! Last Friday, the Tiger football team traveled to Rosemount to take on the 5-0 Irish. The Tigers knew it would be a tough test. Rosemount held on to a 10-0 lead late in the third quarter. That's when the Tigers cranked up the offense. Cole Hendrickson got the passing game going with this 35-yard strike to Tim Robertson. Cole is 19 of 25 for 261 yards in the night. Then on the ground, it was Xander Hall getting the carry from the 5-yard line and putting the Tigers on the board. Hall wasn't done, though, as minutes later he burst up the middle for 35 yards to score and ice the game with his third tee. The defense came up big as well. Here's Brock Morganson with a huge sack to stop an Irish comeback, and the Tigers went on to win 28-17. The Tigers scored 28 points in the last 14 minutes to get their second victory. Tonight, we take on the Eagan Wildcats as Tiger Stadium at 17. Wear your black tonight. The boys' soccer team faced Rochester John Marshall in the playoffs on Tuesday, and the game went into overtime with a 0-0 draw. The game was scoreless in overtime, so it went to a shootout. The Tigers won 5-3, and scoring in the shootout. For the Tigers included Zach Berg, Christian Coles, Cole Eckert, Spencer Cook, Colton Mills. Yesterday, the boys faced Lakeville South and won in overtime with a goal by Spencer Cook and an assist by Isaac Keane. They take on Owatonna in the section finals Tuesday at home. The girls' soccer team faced Rochester Century on Tuesday, and in their playoff run and lost in a shootout, ending with their season with a 5-8-3. The girls and boys cross-country team have their conference meet today at Egan High School. Good luck to them, and that's all for sports. Now we're going to a feature where Adam Jorgensen interviewed math teacher Miss Snobeck.
You may have seen her in class or seen her in the hallways. She's involved in Link Crew and many other school activities. Miss Snobeck has been a teacher of 10 years, and I got a chance to catch up with her and learn more about what makes her a great teacher.
The enthusiasm, and I love homecoming week. I love the dress-up days. This is a nice look, right, for an interview. I just love being part of it. I love that I live 2 miles away, and I can zip over and go to, you know, a football game or a volleyball game or a concert or a play.
From being involved in Link Crew to attending Farmington sports events, Miss Snobeck is one busy person. But a real passion lies in teaching.
You know, I always decided at a young age that I wanted to be a teacher. I think I've always known that I've wanted to do that. And just enjoyed school. Like, I was a kid who was involved in everything in high school, so I just really liked it. And I thought, why not do something I like?
I even got the opportunity to sit down with one of her old students.
When I had Miss Snobeck last year, I really thought she was an amazing teacher, and how she taught her class was quite intuitive, I thought.
When asked about her history with math, she said this.
I worked hard at math. I felt like there were kids in my class that, when I was in high school, I felt like there were kids in my class that got it really quick. And I was a person who I would eventually get it, but I had to work at it a little bit. I had to, you know, I remember sitting in my room at night working on my math homework, laying on my bed.
Despite her love for math, she also has a degree in Spanish and taught the language during her first year of teaching.
I liked math, but probably my favorite subject when I was a student in high school was Spanish. I really enjoyed Spanish, and I actually have a Spanish degree too. My very first year of teaching, I taught Spanish, and then since then I've taught math.
Although we will see Miss Snobeck for many years to come, she said this about retirement.
When I retire from teaching, I plan to spend a lot of time at the cabin. I like to be outside, hiking, traveling. I like to read, I like to jog. I'll probably follow my kids around and bug their families.
There's no doubt she makes a great impact on her students.
I think I've definitely improved on, like, my algebra-related skills, and I have Algebra 2 this year. And I'm really glad she had me do all the missing homework I had, because a lot of the things she taught in geometry comes up in every other math class he takes.
Reporting for Tiger News, I'm Adam Jorgensen.
Mr. Paul is a new art teacher we have here at Farmington High School. This week he is here with us with Adam Jorgensen. Adam?
Thanks, Trinity. Today on the couch we have Mr. Paul, the new art teacher. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. How about you?
I'm doing good. A lot of kids in the building might not know we had a new art teacher, including me, prior to yesterday. So today we're going to ask you a few questions, hopefully get to know you a little better.
Perfect, yeah.
So, where'd you come from and how did you end up here at FHS?
I am from a small town called Little Canada. Mm-hmm. It's not Big Canada, Little yeah. Canada. I graduated from Gustavus Adolphus mm-hmm. College, and then I found my way here, new painting mm-hmm. and drawing teacher.
Awesome, awesome. So, what made you decide to become an art teacher?
It really was my high school art teacher. I took a class with him, we got involved, he asked me to help out with some of his summer teaching, and the rest is history. I loved it.
Awesome. So, what do you like to do in your free time when you're not teaching here?
Well, when I'm not teaching, I love to golf. I'm a big golfer. I'm also just a big sports buff in general, and so I love watching, talking sports. So if you ever want to talk sports, I got an opinion about every team and every sport. So.
Awesome. I also like to golf. It's a fun hobby. Nice. So I got a list of some favorite questions here, and when I ask them, you're just going to tell us your favorite, all right?
Sure, yeah.
So, favorite TV show?
Favorite TV show has got to be The Office. It's got everything.
Oh, yeah, that's a funny one. Favorite restaurant?
Restaurant has to be Taco Bell. Delicious, and it's healthy.
So, favorite movie?
Favorite movie is The Grinch. I think Jim Carrey should have won an Oscar.
Yeah, that was a good one. And then, what's your favorite board game?
Favorite board game probably is going to be Monopoly. I love it. Takes a long time, but usually come out on top.
Mm-hmm. So, finally, where can students find you if they want to meet you?
My room number is 1312, the painting and drawing room. I'd love for you to stop by, mm-hmm. Introduce yourself. You know, maybe we can talk sports or whatever, art in general. But I'd love to see everybody, you know, drop by. I love meeting new people.
Thanks for coming by, Mr. Paul. Definitely make sure to come down to his room if you want to meet him. It was nice meeting you today.
You as well.
Back to the desk with Gunner and Trinity.
Thanks, Adam. I'm glad we got to know a little bit about Mr. Paul because I'll never get to have him as a teacher. Late last month, Officer Kenneth Knox, an officer located out of Georgia, responded to an emergency call of a 2-month-old girl choking on food. With seconds to spare, he arrived at the scene to find the baby on the brink of death. He laid her down and immediately performed what he calls reverse CPR. After a little while, he dislodged the cereal and saved her life. 1 week after the encounter, the child's parents requested that Knox be her godfather, an offer he quickly accepted. Knox said that in his 25 years of being a cop, that was his greatest accomplishment and made every second of those 25 years worth it all.
On Wednesday, Amazon launched Amazon Music Unlimited, a service that is working with Spotify and Apple Music. It is priced at $10 a month, just like Spotify. Amazon created this because they wanted an easy music service because, as Steve Boom, Amazon's vice president, says, the need for music these days has gone up so much that I felt like we needed something like other music streamers. Now we have weather with Kaylin.
The forecast for this week is going to be honest, pretty gloomy. Today it's going to be relatively sunny at least, and highs will be in the 60s, lows will be in the 50s, and that's kind of what we're going to see for the whole week. Saturday, you know, we're going to have thunderstorms. Sunday it's going to be cloudy again. Monday, cloudy. Tuesday, partly cloudy. So we at least have that for us, but it's just going to get cold and it's going to be gross. So this week on Kaylin's Cat Corner, the cat breed of the week is the Savannah, which is the largest cat breed in the world, and it was bred with wild servals. They have a lot of catitude and are twice the size of a normal house cat. So that's the cat fact of the week, and back to the desk with Trinity and Gunner.
So, Gunner, are you donating blood today?
Yeah, I'm donating like 10 minutes after the show.
Oh, awesome.
All right, now we have a Q&A segment.
Tiger News, I'm David Burville.
I'm Zach Boyer.
Today we're going to be asking people if they're donating blood. So, are you donating blood?
No, I'm not.
Did you know donating blood can save 3 lives? I didn't. Nice. So, are you donating blood?
No.
Yes.
Are you donating blood today?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't want to. I don't like needles.
Are you guys going to be donating blood?
No, I'm only 15.
No, I'm 14.
So, Ms. Chachi, are you donating blood?
Yeah, I always donate blood.
Yep. All right, good guy.
Do you know why?
Oh my gosh.
Because I love the cookies.
He loves the cookies.
Are you going to be donating blood?
Yes.
Yeah. Woo. Are you going to be donating blood?
No.
You know donating blood saves 3 lives, right?
Yeah.
I'm Zach Boyer.
I'm David.
And we're going live to the blood drive.
Hi, I'm Summer Welch, and I'm here with
Mrs. Beckman
and Mrs. Johnson.
And we're here live at the blood drive. And so, why are people donating blood today?
They are donating blood today because they can save up to 3 lives with every pint that they donate. It's a really good cause.
So how many people are donating?
We have about 140 signed up. Some students get deferred because of places they've traveled or their weight. But if you think about how many people are donating, we should still get around 120 times the 3 lives per. That's a lot of math. Do it.
All right. So do you know where the blood is going?
Not right now. It kind of depends. They were trying to get a lot of blood for the Hurricane Matthew that was coming in. They thought that was going to be pretty devastating, but didn't hit the United States as hard. But students can take the little barcode that they're given after they're done donating and track their impact and kind of see where that blood ended up once it gets shipped to where it needs to be.
All right. Well, thank you for letting us interview you. Now we're going to ask some other people why they're donating. Hello. What's your name?
I'm Jessie.
All right. So why are you donating blood today?
Because I like saving lives.
All right. Are you nervous at all?
No. All right.
Well, good luck, and I hope you do good. I think that's all we have for you guys today. Back to you guys at the desk.
That's all we have for you today, Farmington High School. I'm Trinity.
I'm Gunner.
I'm Kaylin.
We leave you today with the marching band.
say at times you're hot.